believer closer to the Lord, or drawing an unbeliever into a family. And so our life has to be one that is constantly coming before the Father and desiring to want to live a life in our own way of living that is pleasing to Him, so that through us He can be able to bring goodness to people through His work in your life and in my life, and His word that has been changing our life and can change their life. It's the power of God's word that changes lives. In chapter 4, verse 6, this is what he says. If you point these things out to the brothers, you will be a good minister of Christ Jesus, brought up in the truths of the faith and of the good teaching that you have followed. You see, being a good minister means applying it to my own life. We're going to find that out too in a little bit. But having our own hearts brought up in the truth and the faith, as Paul was saying to Timothy, that you were brought up in the truth and faith, and the good teachings that you have followed. We have to constantly be following after good teaching. There's good men that teach the Word of God. There is the good word that they teach. And it's following after the things that we're learning that come from God. In chapter 6, we want to look at an example here now. Paul said to Timothy, "Fight the good fight of the faith. Take hold of eternal life to which you were called when you made your good confession." That good confession was maybe for you and for me when we were baptized, when we publicly confessed Jesus Christ as our Lord and our Savior, and when we were buried with Him in baptism and raised to walk in newness of life. The life that now lives in us needs to be more and more of Jesus Christ living His life in and through us. That's what Paul said in Galatians 2:20. So Paul is saying here, fight the good fight of faith. Lay hold of eternal life, to which you made a good confession. Now, Paul talks about the most perfect confession when he goes on and tells about Jesus. In the sight of God, who gives life to everything, and of Christ Jesus, who while testifying before Pontius Pilate made the good confession, I charge you to keep this command without spot or blame until the appearing of our Lord Jesus Christ. Jesus gave a good confession to Pilate. He said, I came to bear witness of the truth, and those that listen to me listen to the truth. Of course, Pilate would say, like anybody who is an ungodly person, what is truth? People that don't know the truth that came down from heaven, Jesus Christ Himself being the way, the truth, and the life, and that He was full of grace and truth, they don't realize that the truth has to come from God, because every single thing that's in this world is from the enemy of God. And he is a liar. He's the father of lies. Jesus called him that in John chapter 8. And so we don't want to be ones that are following a liar at all in our life. And so being like Jesus Christ means to have a good confession. Living a good life, our good deeds, good words that come from our mouths that encourage and strengthen and building up people and drawing people into the faith. Going on, I want us to look at Titus chapter 3, verses 1 and 2 for a moment. This is what he says. Remind the people to be subject to rulers and authorities, to be obedient, to be ready to do what is good, to slander no one, to be peaceable and considerate, and to show true humility toward all men. Humility is being humble. We have to be humble. before God and before people. It doesn't matter who it is, whether it is a ruler or someone in authority over us, we need to be obedient and be ready to do whatever is good. That may seem to be hard, but that striving, that agonizing to enter through the narrow gate, again, as I mentioned earlier, it has to be something that is worked out. It takes the disciplines of Christian living in order to work out these, the fruit of the Spirit, for example. And to be peaceable and considerate and be humble toward all men. That's an act of God, and only God can do it in you and me. In verse 8 it says, and that's Titus chapter 3, this is a trustworthy saying, and I want you to stress these things so that those who have trusted in God may be careful to devote themselves to doing what is good. These things are excellent and profitable for everyone. The things that are excellent and profitable for you and me is devoting ourselves to do that which is good. In God's eyes, Him that does that which is pleasing in His sight, in you and in me. Say a lot about that, but I want us to go on a little further. Peter said this. Now we look at what Paul had to say about the goodness that comes from God and doing and being good in how we conduct ourselves and how we communicate with people. But here's what Peter had to say in 1 Peter chapter 3, verse 13. Who is going to harm you if you are eager to do good? But even if you should suffer for what is right, you are blessed. Do not fear what they fear. Do not be frightened. You see, you and I don't have the world to dictate to us how we are to conduct ourselves, how we are to live and communicate with people. We have the Word of God. We have the example that Jesus Christ set for us, and all of those that have gone before us that are godly men and women, those who have set an example for us to follow. And it always is going to lead us right back to what God says, being willing to suffer for the Lord Jesus Christ, for His namesake. If you suffer for doing anything that is good, you're blessed. And God is honored. Don't be afraid of what people are afraid of, what they worry about all the time. But learn how to cast your cares on the Lord and knowing that He will work everything together for good for you because you love Him and you have been called according to His purpose, and that is to conform you to the image of Jesus Christ, to make you God-like men and women that God is pleased with, so He can say, well done, my good servant. That is what is honoring to God. In chapter 2, going back just a moment, in verse 18, this is what he says. Slaves, subject yourselves to your masters with all respect, not only to those who are good and considerate, but also to those who are harsh. For it is commendable if a man bears up under the pain of unjust suffering because he is conscious of God. But how is it to your credit if you receive a beating for doing wrong and endure it? But if you suffer for doing good and you endure it, this is commendable before God. To this you were called, because Jesus suffered for you, leaving you an example that you should follow in His steps. Beloved, nobody can say it better than God Himself, what it is that is honoring and pleasing to Him. And the desire that is in His heart, it needs to be the desire that is in our heart, to live a life that is well-pleasing to God, like Jesus did. I do always those things that please my Father. And the desire that should be in your heart and in my heart as well is I always want to do those things that please Jesus and my Father. And if that is the motive and that is the desire of your heart, God will bless that. And God will honor his name in and through you and me as we avail ourselves to what he teaches us in his word. My prayer for you, as it is for myself as well, that we would seek the goodness of God in everything that we do, and not try to please man, but to please God. That is honorable in his sight. God bless you, is my prayer.